Hey guys, it's John V here with Phone Arena. So 2018 is finally underway and I bet you're pretty excited about some upcoming devices on the horizon. CES is right around the corner and then in late February, we'll have MWC, so you know that we're gonna hear about a ton of new smartphones. But the most anticipated phone for the first half of the year is arguably gonna be the Samsung Galaxy S9. Samsung's position in the landscape has covered the gamut. They made some great decisions, some bad decisions as well, but they are here today because of all of them. Obviously, they've come a long way, so it's intriguing to see what they did in the past to get them to where they're at right now. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about 10 phones that redefined Samsung's identity. So we're going to start off this list with Samsung's very first Android smartphone, and that's the Samsung Galaxy i7500. It's notable for being the phone that launched the Galaxy line, and it's actually the company's first foray into the Android circle. It was a gamble, given that Google's platform wasn't still well established back then. Still though, the move definitely sparked Samsung to commit to this relatively unknown, unproven platform, and it really did pay off for them. So while it didn't sell in huge numbers, the Galaxy i7500 definitely established a brand new identity for them, one that involved Android going forward and shifting away from its typical feature phones and Windows Mobile phones businesses. Now speaking of Windows Mobile phones, our next device on this list is the Samsung Blackjack, which was a portrait quality smartphone released back in 2006. Before adopting Android fully, Samsung, much like everyone else, was heavily invested in the Windows Mobile platform. The Blackjack is notable for reshaping Samsung's identity in many ways. First of all, it adopted the trend of offering this portrait-style QWERTY device and even rivaled the Moto Q before it. On top of that, Samsung gambled on the phone's name, the Blackjack, just because, as you could probably tell, some people mistook it for BlackBerry. That resulted in Research in Motion at the time filing a lawsuit for copyright infringement, and given how Samsung wasn't an established brand at the time, it seemed like Samsung was in for a bumpy ride. But somehow, they managed to stand their ground and the two companies eventually came to a mutual agreement. Now, the terms of the deal weren't disclosed, but regardless, it was an agreement. Ultimately though, this basically showed us that Samsung was willing to stand its ground and become a little bit more adventurous. And on top of that, the Blackjack went down as one of the most memorable Windows phones of all time. Switching gears a bit for our next phone, now this device tried to sell us on the strategy of more is better, but in reality, that's not always the case. Samsung was hitting its stride by the time they released the Samsung Galaxy S4, and that phone brought pretty much everything to the table. It was features rich, and it really sold us on this notion of more is better. From the specs it was packing to all the fast software features in tow with experience, it just overwhelmed a lot of people. It might have looked like Samsung invested a ton of research, development, and time into the Galaxy S4, but it was really notorious for those novel features that it offered. Take for example the smart scroll feature with the web browser. Basically, you could scroll up and down by just tilting your head. Now this seemed kinda cool at first, but over time it definitely seemed more gimmicky than anything else. And then you had even more features like S-Voice, all those air gestures, the air review functionality, the list kept on going on and on. Obviously, the phone was just out of control when it came to all these software features, and in the long run, it kind of bruised the company's ego, just because given how many of the features found in the S4 were slowly phased out, it really makes you wonder what kind of impact this had with Samsung's identity. And since then, we haven't seen a phone with as many features. Breaking ground in a slightly different form factor, the Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge was without question taking more of the spotlight when it was introduced alongside the redesigned Galaxy S6. This new aesthetic came a few short months after the release of the Samsung Galaxy Note Edge, which only featured one side with a curved edge, but this one here had both edges curved. So even though Samsung did add some functions to those dual curve edges, like the ticker function and even quick glances or multitasking, it was primarily done for cosmetic purposes. It wasn't a bad decision because obviously they adopted this dual curve screen form factor into its other devices down the road. Samsung ventured into new territory with the Galaxy S6 Edge, and it was the precedent for Samsung's designs going forward. However, if we're to look back and really recognize just one single phone that was the catalyst for change, when it came to Samsung's phone designs, it has to be none other than the Samsung Galaxy Alpha. It was released back in the fall of 2014, and it really did change Samsung's reputation for making these underwhelming, boring-looking designs with its phones. While it wasn't a huge redesign, the Galaxy Alpha was different and a departure for Samsung because they did offer some premium materials for a change. The biggest thing about it was that Samsung finally employed metal in its design. It featured this brand new metal trim that outlined the phone, and it really looked slick. Yes, it was still sporting some plastic elements with the design, but the shift in adopting metal was a clear sign of bigger things to come. Before Samsung invested a lot of its time into making Android smartphones, the majority of the company's efforts was placed on its feature phones. The most notable one that redefined its identity has to be the Samsung Instinct, which is a response to the Apple iPhone. The phone got a lot of attention because it attacked some of the shortcomings of the iPhone while obviously praising its superiority. It featured things that the iPhone didn't, like faster 3G data connectivity, turn-by-turn navigation with built-in GPS. You could even download songs directly over the air onto the phone, watch television, and you had also the ability to record and send videos. The marketing for this phone was fierce because in commercials, they constantly compared to the iPhone and they did a lot of side-by-side comparisons. Given that Samsung's venture into Android was still a year away, the Samsung Instinct helped to instill just some degree of confidence into the company. And it did prove to be a big distraction to the iPhone. The next phone on our list to redefine Samsung's identity had this idea of bigger is better, and that was the original Samsung Galaxy Note. It was released in the fall of 2011, and it proved to be the driving force that spurred this brand new line and form factor. It helped to popularize this term phablet, which is a device combining the elements of a phone and tablet together. This smartphone was compelling on so many levels, from its larger-than-life stature to the top-shelf specs, and even its ability to spur conversation from random strangers because of its sheer size. The Galaxy Note helped to elevate Samsung's reputation to a higher level. It even helped to reintroduce the stylus, which we all thought was dead since the advent of capacitive touchscreens, but the S Pen was a useful tool that really complemented the phone. The Galaxy Note eventually helped solidify Samsung's reputation as a premier player, and even now, after all that time has passed, the Galaxy Note line continues to be one of the most popular and anticipated smartphones around. Samsung has been making Android-powered smartphones since the late 2000s, but it wasn't until 2010 until we saw its first major flagship model, the Samsung Galaxy S. The phone ushered in a brand new era for the company, one that enabled them to not only be a force in the Android sphere, but in the overall smartphone market. By coming out with this flagship handset, it reshaped Samsung's identity into a premier maker. No longer were they just going to settle on making these mid-ranger phones, but they're going to spend a lot more time and development into this flagship line. It was a pivotal moment for Samsung because they're still trying to claw their way out from the rest of the competition at the time. You had companies like Motorola, HTC, LG that were offering equally as compelling smartphones, but the Galaxy S was the phone that allowed them to really be regarded as a serious contender. There have been several milestones and achievements in Samsung's history, but at the same time too, we did see a few mishaps along the way. One of the biggest ones that redefined Samsung's identity was the events that transpired with the Samsung Galaxy Note 7 during the fall of 2016. Many people will agree that it remains to be one of the biggest failures for them, and it definitely left a scar. By now we know the story, but basically what happened was that we had initial reports about phones exploding randomly, and ultimately the culprit behind the explosions was determined to be the battery. Initially, they did announce a recall for the smartphone just to replace those faulty batteries, but things got worse because those replacement units were also exploding later on. Things didn't get any better, and the company eventually had to come to the decision of discontinuing the phone altogether. Seriously, it was a really bad time for Samsung just because its quality assurance procedures were questioned. It left a black eye on the company, and the result from all of it was missed expectations from a financial standpoint. At the end of the day, it was one tough lesson learned by Samsung, but luckily it helped them to strive to do better, which was evident in the release of the Galaxy S8 and Note 8 later on. Before we get to the number one phone that redefines Samsung's identity, we're going to go through some honorable mentions very quickly. Many people will argue that the Samsung Galaxy Nexus was the pinnacle in Google's now defunct Nexus line. But for Samsung, the Galaxy branding attached to the Nexus line only elevated its position in the overall space. After the disaster with the Note 7, Samsung bounced back with the Galaxy S8, and it was an astounding success. They committed to tighter and more meticulous quality control and testing of its devices to ensure that they were safe. The Samsung Omnia was the company's last great smartphone for Microsoft's Windows Mobile platform. It featured that all-screen form factor, you had a stylus, an optical mouse, and even a hefty 5-megapixel rear camera at the time. But by the time it came out, Windows Mobile as a whole was on the decline, and Android was only getting started. Samsung went out of its way to develop its own mobile operating system with Bada, and the first phone to feature it was the Samsung Wave S8500. It was a tough lesson learned because Samsung was also investing a lot of time into Android devices, and in a few short years, Bada folded and was eventually merged with Tizen. When it comes to AMOLED screens, we know that Samsung makes some of the best out there, but the very first device to launch in the US with one was the Samsung Impression. It was released in 2009 and it was nothing more than a landscape QWERTY slider feature phone, but it did show us the beauty and wonder of AMOLED technology. After two solid attempts at its flagship line, Samsung finally got the recipe right with the Samsung Galaxy S3. It took some time, but this phone was deemed the first true iPhone killer. The Galaxy S3 also catapulted Samsung into uncharted territory just because they were finally able to move ahead of its rivals in the Android space. Not only was it able to also rival sales of the iPhone, it was a big deal for Samsung too because it was proven to be a critical and commercial hit. It was the first time we saw in the Galaxy S line to be unified, meaning that all four major carriers got the same exact device. Prior to the Samsung Galaxy S3, Samsung's position in the space was pretty much on even level with some of the other Android makers out there. It was still nowhere close to what Apple was doing, but after it, it proved that Samsung was a force to be reckoned with. This was the phone that transformed Samsung into that big fish in the pond.
So what other phones do you think should have been on the list? Leave a message in the comments below and I'll check them out. So if you guys want to learn more about any of the phones I talked about in this video, you could check out our website, phonearena.com. This is John V, signing off.